We were here with Joel Diaz. Joel, introduce who's in the table with us really quick. Who's here?
Marcelino Lopez, strength and conditioning coach and nutritionist, Federico Wintenkamp.
Federico, ¿cómo estás? Marcelino?
Oh, yeah.
I said yesterday, I've never seen a fighter with a physique like his yesterday. He looks like Mr. Olympia, he's ready to compete in a bodybuilding. He's a boxer, but he's very, very ripped. You don't always see that with fighters, bro. Look at that. Tell him, I've never seen a fighter like that.
Dice que nunca ha mirado un peleador que tenga el cuerpo así.
Gracias.
Let me tell you.
Actually, this is what.
This is exactly when you approach the table today. That's exactly what we're talking about. He's telling me, basically, what he's telling me is this: every coach is supposed to have a team where they don't have to worry about anything else. He's telling me, he goes, you're not supposed to worry about nothing. He says, when we got here, he says, have you been stressed? No. Have you been worried? No. Because what has he been doing? He's been resting because he was on weight since he got here. And this guy is from Argentina. He is a strength and conditioning coach, and he's a nutritionist. And he has some experience. He went to school to become a doctor, but he didn't finish. He knows, and he's telling me how the system works, how many times a fighter should eat. Because he works with him, Ruslan Madiev, and Bobby Jones, Momimov, and they're all the same. They all look the same. They look like bodybuilders. But like he says, you have to feed them a certain time of the day, so many times a day. And he's basically explaining to me how the system works, how the body works. He goes, you should have fighters in camp where they're supposed to eat at the same time, and the portions that they're supposed to be provided for them, so you don't have to worry like Marcelino. He says, every fighter supposed to come to a fight before the weigh-ins and rest, not having to be stressing on the scale or going to a gym. He says, and I can help you with that, but because he's been helping with some of the fighters, and he's really good at what he does. And he says, all these fighters, they got managers. All they have to do is just provide you for food and the training, and we can put it together. Because when you know what you're doing, you don't need to be stressing the day of the weigh-ins.
It's true, but you've had Tim Bradley, who was also ripped like a crocodile. But Tim wasn't a big puncher. He'll need to tell you himself. He's not knocking anything. This guy puts people asleep if he just looks at them. Most of the time, fighters are not ripped. Joel, we've seen guys in the gym that are all ripped, get in there and get knocked out and sparring. What is this, like, how does that help him being all... So boxing, most box fighters are not all yoked out.
You know, a lot of fighters that have a physique like Marcelino Lopez, they usually work really hard to get that body. Marcelino, basically what he does is he doesn't do any weightlifting or anything. All he does is just conditioning and boxing. Basically, I don't know, genetically, that's how his body is.
And his diet, of course.
Yeah, and his diet and stuff. But he's not one of those guys that is at the gym lifting weights and stuff. He's not. He doesn't do that. It's boxing, conditioning, medicine ball, little dumbbells here and there, you know, running, sparring. That's about it. But there's fighters that really, they get really yoked up.
Yeah.
And they have no power. They have no power because they got so much muscle.
And the oxygen and the blood cells slow them down.
Marcelino knows how to use his power. His flexibility.
Muy fuerte.
Because him and I, always in contact and what he wants me to do. Like I tell him, Marcelino, I just need for him to be strong and fast. He has power. I just need him to be more flexible. So he works on that. And that's the work that you can see when you got a strengthening and conditioning coach and a boxing coach together in communication.
On the same page,
On the same page.
You've had fighters from all over the world. You've had fighters from all different kind of levels. Where do you place Marcelino Lopez of all the guys you ever trained?
Oh, Marcelino is, he's at the top. He's at the top. All he needs to do is get that activity so that he can get known and be placed at that level. Obviously, I mean, the circumstances of his manager promotional issues have him where he is now, but honestly, if it wasn't for that, he would probably be a world champion by now. Hopefully now that after today, he gets more activity and he stays busier fighting constantly so that he can, you know, get the opportunity for a world title because he is among one of the best 140 pounders out there, but he just needs that opportunity.
Jose Ramirez, Josh Taylor, who wins, and what do you think about the winner against him?
I think, you know what, I think that fight is a good fight. Honestly, to me, it's more like, it's not a 50-50 fight. I lean a little more towards Ramirez style. Josh Taylor is a great fighter, but I think Ramirez, being a Mexican, his heart is going to prevail on the fight. And then, I mean, that will be a great fight. Marcelino Lopez and Ramirez will be a great fight. Argentina versus Mexico, and, you know, Marcelino has a great boxing ability, great boxing style, has a lot of power. And also, he carries some of the Mexican style in him, you know. So I think it will be a better fight, you know, if in the future we have the opportunity and the privilege to see a fight like Ramirez and Marcelino Lopez.